went to work for her that summer. A teenage kid so far from home. She was a lonely widow woman, hell-bent to make it on her own. We were 1,000 miles from nowhere, wheat fields as far as I could see. Both needing something from each other, not knowing yet what that might be. Till she came to me one evening, hot cup of coffee and a smile, in a dress that I was certain she hadn't worn in quite a while. There was a difference in her laughter, there was a softness in her eyes, and on the air there was a hunger even a boy could recognize. She had a need to feel the thunder, to chase the lightning from the sky, to watch a storm with all its wonder raging in her lover's eyes. She had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong. Summer wind was all around me, nothing between us but the night. When I told her that I'd never, she softly whispered, "That's all right." And then I watched her hands of leather turn to velvet in a touch. There's never been another summer when I have ever learned so much. She had a need to feel the thunder, to chase the lightning from the sky, to watch a storm with all its wonder raging in each other's eyes. She had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind. Now their only dreams have been burning both ends of the night. I often think about that summer, the sweat, the moonlight, and the lakes. And I have rarely held another when I haven't seen her face. And every time I pass a wheat field and watch it dancing in the wind, although I know it isn't real, I just can't help but feel her hungry arms again. She had a need to feel the thunder, chase the lightning from the sky, to watch a storm with all its wonder raging in her lover's eyes. She had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind. Now their only dreams have been burning both ends of the night, rushing headlong in the wind. Now we're